Oh, hey, Jack. How are you?
Frank, what? How'd you know I was here?
Well, that guy outside, he said this one was your place.
What, did he tell you just to come in and make yourself at home?
Oh, no, I tried the door and it was open. I'm sorry.
No, no, it's okay. Man, I've had a crazy day.
Well, listen, I hate to burn you with this, but listen.
Can I get you anything?
Harris has these guys, and they're gonna kick my ass if I don't pay him his money.
What do you want me to do about it? Pay him.
Harris says I know where you're hiding.
First of all, I'm not really hiding. Second of all, you would never tell him where I was hiding because you're my friend, right?
Oh, Jack, I'm not threatening you.
Things are gonna get really weird around here if it seems like you're threatening me and the next thing you know, I'm threatening you and then...
Listen, I'm desperate for this money and we're friends, right?
How much do you owe Harris?
$1,500.
You think I got $1,500?
No, no, but you know how to get that kind of money.
Okay. I got one thing I'm kind of working on. Maybe I can work you in.
Yes, please. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks. What, you want to tell me about it now?
I'm still working out the details. Let me surprise you.
Thanks. Thanks, man. What do you think?
How many we got here today?
I count 20 cars, but they're all down at the beach.
Okay. You wait here.
Yes.
Anybody comes, you still
okay.
Wait here.
All right. Perfect. What if the cops come by or something?
Just watch them roll by. Are you getting nervous?
No.
You having second thoughts?
No, no. I just want to, you know, make sure I'm doing it right, you know? Everything's cool.
Who's ever sure if it's cool? It's open. He took a bullet for me. Bless his heart.
How did he get in here? How did he know where the key was?
Oh!
Jesus, lady! You shot me!
Quite a bounce you've got. You must be part jackrabbit.
More of a wildcat, really. I'm Edwards, bachelor from Tennessee. Maybe you heard of me.
Why would you have heard of me?
That never hurts to ask, though, does it?
I'm Charles Ingalls. It's nice to meet you, Edwards.
Nice meeting you, too. You know, I heard about all this free land out here in Kansas, and I said, sign me up. Well, of course, I said that to myself. Thought I'd become a gentleman farmer, although I've never really been much of either.
Well, I came down with my family from Pepin, Wisconsin.
Pepin?
Have you been there?
No.
You know folks from there?
No.
You ever heard of it?
No, but I bet it's pretty. Yeah. Hey, where did you do your homesteading?
Right over there, about 3/4 mile.
No kidding. No, I'm right up over here. We're neighbors. How's your house coming along?
Slowly.
Yeah, mine too. You know, we should make a deal. We should make a deal and help each other out. That's what we should do. We should make a deal. That's what neighbors do. They help each other out. We could start with your home because your family needs shelter. And I'm just a bachelor with few needs.
Right. Just a wildcat from Tennessee.
Well, now you're catching on, Mr. Ingalls. What do you say, deal?
I don't know what Amanda's been telling you or what.
I don't think you appreciate the seriousness of this conversation. God damn it.
Now, come on, Earl. You're not gonna shoot me.
No!
Now, I know you, buddy. You can't kill a deer, so just put the gun down. Just put it down.
You're right. The fact is, you're gonna shoot me.
Now I'm a little confused.
I can't stop thinking about it, Clay. Ever since she told me, she was a virgin when we was married.
I remember her being a little wild in high school.
You're straying! Now pick up the gun.
You know, you're making way too much of this. Man, I mean, we're both a little too fucking drunk. Let's sober up a little. This is a lot of fucking control, don't you think?
I can't have the whole goddamn town knowing what happened. And it ain't easy for me. You be my best friend and all, but you won't pay, you son of a bitch. Not with your life, but you're gonna do some time, that's for sure.
Now, Earl. You're a little out of it right now.
Yeah, you think so?
You're a little out of your mind. Right now, yes, you're a little fucking crazy.
Oh, yeah? Crazy? Crazy enough to tell people we was coming up here shooting today? Crazy enough to tell Amanda that me and you was gonna have it out over this here very issue? Crazy enough to bring both of the trucks up here? Because it'll be one thing hiding my body, it's gonna be another thing getting both these trucks out of here. I thought it all out, Clay. Now be a man and pick up the gun.
Earl, I'm not gonna pick up the gun. Earl.
Good luck explaining me dying with a bullet from your gun, buddy.
Put the gun down.
I bet you don't think I got the nerve, do you?
You got the nerve. You got the fucking nerve, but you're scaring the shit out of me. Jesus. Oh, put the fucking gun down.
Rule out the suicide angle, lover boy.
It's unworthy. She doesn't mean shit to me. I don't fucking care about her. Don't fucking do this.
What's up?
They're sending them back. The convoy's headed back to base camp.
We're gonna hold the perimeter, and we're gonna hold the strong point. Hua?
Hey, Kurth. It's 11 hours behind. That makes it Sunday morning, 10 a.m. in Ohio right now.
Would you shut up, man? Who the hell gives a shit?
I know my dad is out mowing the lawn, and I know my mom's power walking, and I bet all I got, my buddies are teeing off the back nine of Tinglewood. That's weird to think about.
You changed the coordinates, didn't you, General?
That's affirmative, Captain.
So now they think we're gutless? The feds? They think we won't actually do it.
They're gonna come at us with everything they got. Air and sea. They're gonna bomb our ass back to the Stone Age.
They don't know we missed on purpose.
Great. We're not gutless or incompetent. That right?
I don't think I like your tone, Captain. We planned for this contingency. Load the VX into the choppers, take four hostages, and evacuate. Consequences of our actions I'll face alone.
Excuse me, General, but what about the fucking money?
There is no fucking money. Mission's over.
Bullshit, it's over.
You're talking to a general, soldier. Maintain discipline.
I'm not a soldier, Major. The day we took hostages, we became mercenaries. And mercenaries get paid. I want my fucking money!
This mission was based on the threat of force. I'm not about to kill 80,000 innocent people. Do you think I'm out of my fucking mind? We bluffed. They called it. The mission's over.
Whoever said anything about bluffing, General?
Stand down, Captain.
Stand down, Captain!
I joined the Army because I am the oldest of eight. I have four real brothers and two step-brothers and a little stepsister. I worry a lot about them now because I ain't there no more. But I am hoping that by being a soldier in the United States Army, it will give them someone that they can look up to. And not just because I'm tall.